retain the mining rights to a piece of land. This can be done legally or illegally. Next, pay someone to provide false resource status reports and use these as leverage to gain investors for your project. Afterwards, get your company to attract press coverage to exaggerate the amount of resources you have found. This will drive up the price of the shares. If no gold is found, no problem. You can liquidate the company, making a huge profit, and leave the messy business of cleaning up to your investors. Repeat this process a number of times in Australia, Britain, and Sierra Leone. I hope you wrote this down. And now, when an opportunity comes up to acquire the rights to a mining region in your home country, Romania, legally or illegally, take the following steps. One, use one of your tax evading companies from Toronto to set up a deal with the Romanian government. Step two, create a company with your government friends with a friendly sounding name like Roşia Montană Gold Corporation.
Sounds great.
Make sure you own at least 80% of this company. Open up the other 20% to a public bid, but make sure your government friends secretly win the contract the day before. Raise huge amounts of capital from your investors so that you can start buying up property in the town. Continue to do this until you own vast amounts of land. Ask the government to create a new law that allows you to bypass those pesky environmental and heritage laws blocking your project. And remember, don't let bones of the dead people get in your way. Just throw them on the street. If you follow these steps correctly, congratulations. You now hold the power.
A country and my mayor of the system, Mina Moroshka. We sold our house and decided to buy a new one. Eram venit atunci ca să-mi pot măcar imagina ce s-a întâmplat, dar tot ce știu e că my mother told me that when I first came into our new house, I started crying and shouting, I wanted to get out of here.